Hey, Byron.
Hey, Rich.
Knock, knock.
Oh, who is there?
Deleted.
Deleted who?
Deleted scenes time.
Oh, I love deleted scenes time. It's deleted scenes time, folks. So these are scenes that we deleted.
From the movie.
From the movie, yep.
They're out, but they're back now
for you,
for us to watch.
So here we go. So enjoy.
Okay, this first deleted scene is called Alternate Opening.
An opening that is alternate, a different way into the film, completely from what you know. This was our way to both establish the world and Judy's character. So you'll see Judy as a young rabbit, and you also get to learn that Judy is unhappy with the rabbit's lot in life.
And we also see Judy come to the rescue of another classmate who's stuck up in a tree, a little bobcat kid.
Bobby Catmull.
Named Bobby Catmull. The scene became the bullying scene with Gideon Gray because we realized we needed Judy to be the victim of bias.
And also to set up why she's got a thing about foxes, as much as she doesn't want to believe that. So that's what that did.
Well, here we go. Let's watch it.
Thousands of years ago, the world was a dangerous place. A place where predator and prey didn't get along. A place where savage beasts lurked in every shadow. Blood, 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 and death. And that is why I'm glad I live today, because back then, I would be one.
That was just terrific. Okay, that's enough. It's very graphic. Okay, thank you, Fawn and how you are.
Fawn, pick up your intestines. Thank you.
Hey, that was great. You had me at blood.
Hey guys, could you straighten that banner? The other, no, your side goes up there, Hilda. There you go. Okay, Melody Mammals, you're up. Rory, Woody, Sally, and Judy. Two, three, four.
What do we love about our city? That's why we sing this little ditty. We'll all be what we want to be, cause Zootopia gives us opportunity.
I wanna work with wood, cause I'm a woodchuck.
I'm a raccoon, so I'm gonna drive a trash truck.
Squirrels like me wanna sell some nuts.
And I'm a bunny, so, I wanna grow carrots.
I don't wanna grow carrots.
What is your problem?
What? I don't.
Everyone take a five. Judy, it's just a song.
Well, it makes it sound like because I'm a rabbit, I only have a future in carrots. What if I want to be an astronaut? Or a paramedic? Or
Judy, look, certain mammals are just better at some things than others. When I was your age, I wanted to be a firefighter. But armadillos ball up at the first sign of danger, so I became a teacher.
Mrs. Armadillo!
Hang on, Warren.
Look,
I'm not saying you can't be what you want to be. I'm saying that what you want to be should be realistic.
Mrs. Armadillo! Mrs. Armadillo!
In a moment, Warren. I'm talking to...
But Bobby Camel's up the tree again!
What?
Look!
Oh, no! Oh, no! Oh, oh, goodness! Okay, Bobby, just stay calm.
I climbed up and I can't get down.
Take a deep breath, just like last time.
I don't know why I did that.
That branch isn't gonna hold him.
He's gonna fall.
Ah, somebody call the police. Ah.
He's gonna fall.
Oh, what is that? Wait, what? Oh,
what?
I can get it. Come on. Oh, come back, you little rascal.
Well, that was some quick thinking.
What's your name, young lady?
Judy Hopps, sir.
Well, Judy Hopps, you are a hero. You know, you should think about being a police officer.
Her? She can't be a cop. She's just a bunny.
Listen, son. This is Zootopia, where anyone can be anything.
This deleted scene is called Nick's Wild Time Pitch. And originally in the story, prey animals kind of ran Zootopia. Mm-hmm. And they made predators wear these shock collars to make the prey feel safe around them.
It's like a public safety measure called terror.
Right. So if predators became agitated or emotional, the collar would give them a little shock, and it made the prey animals feel better, but it was kind of oppressive.
Yeah, and in this world, Nick had a great idea for a business, a money-making venture called Wild Times, where predators could actually take their collars off and behave like predators and chase things and go on this thing called Aurora Coaster, which is like a roller coaster that lets them roar and be themselves. And so it was a perfect money-making venture for Nick. However, he had none of this.
None of this.
None of this. No,
no dinero.
No capital. No dinero.
None of the lettuce.
Poor. And he was a poor guy and he needed to make some money, and he had to go to all these banks that are all run by prey animals. And at the end of this very frustrating day, Nick finally breaks down and realizes that the prey banks aren't gonna help him, and he's gotta go to Kozlov.
He was a polar bear that was a mob boss.
Yeah. Yeah, so enjoy Nick's Wild Times pitch.
What does every pred in this town want? An escape from everyday life. A place where the only rule is to have fun, a place for them. A place called Wild Times. Okay, now this is a fun zone amusement park exclusively for Zootopia's largest untapped market, Preds. You know, they say you can't put a price on happiness, and I say you can. Bang, there it is, $19.95 a ticket. I have a building lined up, I have the plans, I have the staff, I have a dream. The only thing I don't have is a loan to make it happen, friend. Will you help me make it happen? Will you help me make it happen? Will you help me make it happen? I'm just gonna put it out on the table. You don't like mammals like me, and I do not like mammals like you, but what do we both like? We both like money. You have it, I wanna borrow it, and then we'll both make a lot of it. Hmm? Desperate? I'm not desperate. I am desperate. Look, I get it. No one wants to throw money down a rat hole. By that, I meant no disrespect. They say you can't put a price on happiness. I say hogwash. What? Well, that was an unfortunate. Now, I don't want to beat a dead horse. I'm just going to leave. Over again.
It's not that it's a bad idea. It's, look. There's just too much risk in loaning to mammals without credit.
Well, see, the thing is, I can't get credit if you won't loan to me.
Right, absolutely, and we will be happy to loan to you when you do have the credit. Have you tried any of the other banks, Mr. Wild?
And, I call it Wild Times. I have the plans, I have the staff, and I have a dream. The only thing that I don't have is the loan to make it happen. Will you help me make it happen?
This deleted scene is called Homesick Hops. It's similar to the one you'll see in the movie, but it's different in some very significant ways. So earlier, when she was assigned traffic duty by Bogo in this version, Bogo gave a speech to the cops saying, real cops suck it up, they're tough, they don't get hurt by stuff, and it's like, you gotta stay tough. So Judy, she's feeling really down about herself. She gets home, and she really wants to call her mother for support, but she looks over and she sees that pad that says, suck it up from this morning.
She decides, well, I'm not gonna call home. And when she throws the phone down, she accidentally dials, and her mom does pick up the phone. And the two of them share this heartfelt conversation. And the parents don't find out that she is a meter maid by the end of the conversation. And Judy is really motivated by guilt rather than determination.
Yeah, so enjoy.
Here comes Homesick Hops.
Suck it up. Oh! Oh, no, no, no!
Hey, there's my girl! Told you she'd call. How's the big city, Bun Bun?
Good. It's good.
Use that fox taser?
No, Dad.
But is that Trudy? Ask her if she's been eaten yet.
No, for goodness sake. No one got eaten, Pop-Pop.
Well, foxes are red because they were made by the devil.
Oh, dear. So, tell me about your first day.
Oh, it was really great.
What's wrong?
I'm fine.
You are not fine. Your ears are droopy. You need me to come out there. Stu, pack the car.
No, I'm good. I'm good. I'm just tired from a big day in the field.
Yeah? You out there making the world a better place?
Yep. I'm really making a difference.
Wow. Good for you, Bun Bun. I mean, not that I didn't think you'd make it. It's just, you're doing something I never thought a bunny could do. I guess all you needed was a chance to prove yourself. I'm so proud of you.
Yeah.
You keep making chances for yourself.
Okay.
And keep that fox taser under your pillow. I love you, honey, very much.
I love you guys, too.
Next up, we have a deleted scene called Detective Work. This is a scene that happens right after Judy is awarded the case of Emmett Otterton. And Judy, since she doesn't have a computer of her own, is having to borrow another police officer's computer. The thing is that the computer belongs to an elephant cop who is on paid migration. And the scene is all about the comedy of this little rabbit using a computer of a great big elephant.
And you'll watch this and you'll go, wow, it's beautifully animated, it's charming, it's funny, why did we cut it? And the reason is time, because it was at a point in the movie where we needed to move the story along very quickly, and we also needed to find a way to get Clawhauser in there to establish him as an ally. But some charming animation, enjoy, some fun scale jokes, this is Detective Work.
Clawhauser! I got a case.
Nice. Case of what?
No, a case.
Oh, good for you.
Think I can borrow a desk?
Ooh, take Bob's. He's out on paid migration.
Next up is the original Jumbo Pop scene. The way the scene played when the movie used to be told from Nick's point of view. The point of the scene was to show just how good a con man Nick was and just the lengths that this guy will go to try and fool the elephants and Judy.
The scene was completely animated. Most of these shots are completely lit, so it's a ton of work. This killed us to have to change this because Jason is so funny in this scene, but it wasn't serving the story itself, so we had to make that decision.
So here's the original Jumbo Pop.
Here you go. Oh. Next.
I'll take two vanilla jumbos with extra peanuts and no cherries, please.
Wow. Guess I should get the junior size.
One junior sundae.
Yowzers! Good thing I eat like a horse.
Grab a seat, don't break nothing. We'll bring it to you. Next customer.
Hello. Hey. There I am. One jumbo pop for my boy, please. You want red or blue, pal?
He can't eat all that. Why don't you pick something else?
I'd rather not pick something else. He's been looking forward to this for weeks.
Listen, Fox. He's not gonna finish it. It's gonna drip all over the place, and I'm gonna have to clean up your kid's mess. Pick something different, or go somewhere else.
You're holding up the line.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Excuse me. Now, could we go somewhere else? Sure, but we have come here. Why? Pachydermiopathy. He thinks he's an elephant. Do not smirk, please. He has lived with this affliction his entire life. Every day is a battle. Buddy, give us a little toot. Is that not adorable? I mean, I am not going to be the one to tell him what you're feeling is wrong, that you're just a fox, because that would break his sweet little heart. Do you want to break his sweet little heart?
$15.
Oh, thank you. 15 big ones coming right up. Well, hang on. Oh, no, are you kidding me? Oh, I must have left my wallet at the orphanage.
He's an orphan?
He was, officer. He sure was, but 30 minutes ago, I went ahead and made the best decision of my life. Yeah, I'm a dad. Yeah, and this guy, he's just been through so much. I just want to make him happy. But, I'm sorry, buddy. Gotta be about the worst birthday ever.
And it's his birthday?
It is, the big four. Yeah, Doc said he'd never make it past three, but he's my little fighter.
Wait, sir? If it's his birthday, shouldn't he get it for free?
No free jumbo pops.
No, he's right. If there's one thing that I want to teach him, aside from the ability to speak, it's that in Zootopia there are no free handouts. Even for this sweet, helpless orphan who is blind.
Hi, everybody. Okay, so this next deleted scene is called Hops's apartment. This actually took place at the midpoint of the movie, right after Mr. Monchus had gone savage and Nick had gotten injured during this encounter. So Judy decides to take him to a safe house, which turns out to be her apartment in the city. And when they go in, much to her surprise, is the entire Hopps family, who have come to the city for a visit because they hadn't heard from Judy for a couple days.
And Judy's dad is really upset about Judy having lied to the family about being a meter maid, about befriending a fox. And he wants Judy to go home. And we found that it seemed strange that the dad would have so much power over Judy the way that her boss would. So that's why it eventually became Bogo.
What's the deal?
Who wants to take Judy's badge after the Jaguar attack.
Badge.
And Nick coming to her defense.
What did you say, Fox?
What I said was no. She will not be giving you that badge.
Yeah, and one of the things that I personally miss the most about this particular scene is that there were these great jokes in there with Hopps' dad, Stu, as played by the lovely Rich Moore.
In this right here, version.
This version.
Scratch dialogue.
Scratch dialogue. And Stu was really uncomfortable with the fact that his daughter, Judy, might be dating this fox.
I was worried.
Yeah, he was worried. He was concerned. Rightly so. All right. Enjoy.
You said this was a safe house.
Yeah, safe house. With a space in the middle. A house that is safe.
Yeah, that's cute.
Judy! Oh, thank goodness.
Mom?
You were supposed to call every day, and we got worried. And I mean, in the city, there's all kinds of unsavory animals.
Well, look who brought some breakfast.
Judy, quietly, pass me the fox taser.
You have a fox taser?
Dad, he's with me. It's okay.
He brought a fox to your home?
He's more than a fox, Dad.
Sweet cheese and crackers, he's your boyfriend.
You know what? This has been great. I was actually just leaving.
No, wait.
It's fine.
Honey, if the fox wants to leave.
No, look, he is not the fox. His name is Nick, and he is helping me solve a big case, and he is my friend. And if anyone is uncomfortable being in the same room with him, there's the door.
If you're working a big case, why you got a meter maid uniform?
She's not a meter maid, Thomas. She's a real cop. They gave her a fancy car and everything. Isn't that right, Bun Bun?
Technically, I'm not a real cop yet.
Judy, you lied to me?
Mom,
okay, you know what? That's it. You're going home right now, young lady. Pack it up. Let's go.
Dad.
No, I was worried about you coming here in the first place, and now you're lying and other things, and you know, Judy, this is not who you are.
So she lied about being a meter maid. Okay, look at that vest, son. Hold it up. Look at that thing. Who wouldn't lie about that? Okay, here's the thing. When I first saw Officer Toot Toot here, I thought she's gonna get stepped on. But you know what she said? Bunnies from the burrows do not get stepped on. They step up.
And she has.
So, Dad, can I call you Dad? We only have 12 hours left to solve this big case. And you make her go back to Carrotville now. Gosh, we'll never know if Officer Hopps could be a real cop, will we? All I'm saying is, just give her a chance.
Well, I guess we could give her 12 hours, right, Mother?
There you go. Go on home. Make another baby.
Now, you two be careful, okay? Because there is that savage animal on the loose.
No, Dad, he's not on the loose. The cops got him.
Oh, no, he's still out there. It's all over the news.
Bye. Drive safe.
Honey, just to clarify, he's not your boyfriend, right?
Out.
This next deleted scene is called The Taming Party. This was a very important scene in the early version of the movie where Nick was the main character. It really stuck around a long time because we found it very, very emotionally compelling. In that version of the movie, predators were forced to wear these things called tame collars, which was sort of a rite of passage. And when you were 5 years old, the Europe would give you a taming party where you would receive your tame collar, the Europe then wear for the rest of your life.
Now, Judy had always heard of these taming parties, but she had never really seen one. And it was at this point in the story that she and Nick are hiding from these mobsters, and she gets to see for the first time what it is like for a predator to receive one of these tame collars. And it gives her much, much deeper insight into Nick and his plight.
Mm-hmm.
So let's check it out.
Check out the taming party.
Can we please just find a way out?
Oh, I did. For me.
See you later, sucker! Ha ha! This is not my day!
You ran their plates? Did you get an address?
It doesn't matter. You are going back to the station.
If I go back to the station, I am never getting my life back.
We're not going to talk about it anymore.
Shh. We gotta move.
Why?
Shh. Now.
Okay. Okay. Okay! Where is Morris? Morris! Oh boy, come up
what
here,
is
please.
This? Just where keep are going. You?
Come on, come on. Today, my little Morris is no longer a cub. Today, he becomes
a big bear.
That is right. A big bear.
Is this a taming party?
With this collar, Zootopia welcomes you.
With this collar, Zootopia welcomes me.
With this collar, Zootopia celebrates you.
With this collar, Zootopia celebrates me.
With this collar, Zootopia accepts you.
With this collar, Zootopia accepts me. What's wrong, Papa?
Nothing. Papa is just happy for you.
Thank you, Papa.
Morris. Morris!
Go.